Do you have hard time memorizing anatomical terminology, particularly name of muscles? In today's video, I am going to give you some tips to memorize name of muscles. Okay, name of muscle is kind of complicated. It's not very familiar terminology. Let's say this is pectoralis major. What is pectoralis? And this is biceps brachii. It's not usual terminology, right? But there are some rules that kind of easy to memorize anatomical terminology. I will give you some tips. Name of muscles is composed by several category. It's like place where that is. It's like anterior. Posterior, superior, inferior. These terminologies, these words indicate where muscle is, right? And direction. It's like rectus. Rectus means straight, or oblique. Oblique means diagonal direction. Okay, let's say shape. What kind of shape is that? It's like deltoid. Delta means triangle, or it's like a quadratus. Quadratus means rectangular, right? And I give you some other categories. And size, it's like maximus, minimus, or let's say it's longus. Longus means long. Brevis means short. These words indicate size of muscles. Anything else? The muscles which are close to bones. It's like tibialis, fibularis, femoris, or brachii. Brachii means humerus. Okay, so all the name of muscles are combination of these terminology. Let's look one by one. Let's say this is pectoralis major, pec major. Pec plus major. Pec means chest. Major means big, right? This is big chest muscle. And there is one more tip. If there is comparison, it's major, there should be opposite terminology. What is opposite from major? That's minor. Indeed, there's muscle called pectoralis minor, pec minor. Pec plus minor, small chest muscle. That makes sense. Yay. Next one. This one is very simple. Its shape looks like triangular. What is it? That's deltoid. That's very simple. Let's look this one. This muscle is on humerus. That's on arm. That's brachium, right? Brachium. And this muscle has two fibers on arm. That is biceps brachii. Biceps brachii. Brachii means brachium. That means arm. What does bi mean? Bi means two. And seps means heads. So this is muscles on arm that has two heads. That is why biceps brachii. Okay, and there is kind of same muscle on posterior part of arm. That muscle has three heads, and this muscle is on brachium. Again, this is triceps brachii. Triceps brachii. Tri means three. It's like triangle, right? Tri means three. Three heads brachium. Triceps brachii. Yay! So if you divide these terminologies, you can suggest where muscle is. Simple, right? Then let's go to lower extremity. Let's see, this is lower extremity and this is thigh. This is on femur. This is on thigh. And its shape is like very straight. Okay, this is rectus femoris. Rectus femoris. Rectus means straight. Femoris means femur. Straight muscle on femur. Straight muscle on thigh. Makes sense. What about this one? This muscle is humongous, very big. Humongous means vastus. Okay, vastus means huge, humongous, big. Okay, vastus medialis. This is on medial side. Medialis. Okay, big muscle on medial side. Okay, you can apply another rule. If there is rotation and there's comparison, medialis, there should be lateralis. Lateralis, vastus lateralis, which is this muscle. This is on lateral side, and this is big muscle. Vastus lateralis, makes sense. Plus, deep to rectus femoris, there is another vastus muscle. This is on kind of a intermediate place. So this is vastus intermediaries. Does it make sense? And there's one more rule. Name of muscle indicates its function. What do I mean? This muscle is adductor magnus. Adductor magnus. You can suggest what magnus means. Magnus is like maximum, right? The biggest. Biggest adductor muscle. What is adductor? This is function. That is why this is adductor. Adductor magnus. Biggest adductor muscle. Then if there's size, there should be comparison. It's like adductor longus, long adductor, adductor brevis. Now you can memorize many muscles related to these names, right? Does it make sense? So again, name of muscles are kind of complicated at first time, but if you understand these rules, it's easy to memorize because this is just compound of terminology. So let's go to the lower leg. Now, lower leg is even more complicated. Let's see this muscle, this blue one. This one goes to big toe. By the way, name of this muscle is extensor hallucis longus. Extensor hallucis longus. If you had this muscle at first time, you are like, what the hell this is? Because it's such a long name, right? But if you divide this terminology one by one, it's easy to memorize. Extensor. What kind of function is that? That's extension. Okay, this muscle does extension. But extension for what? Extension for hallucis. Hallucis means big toe. Big toe is here. Okay, this muscle does extension for big toe. And what about size of this muscle? This is long one. This is longus. Extensor hallucis longus. This muscle does extension for big toe, and this is long muscle. Again, if there is longus, there should be brevis. Brevis. Indeed, there is muscle called extensor hallucis brevis. Easy enough, right? Then you can suggest name of this muscle. This muscle is also extensor, but this muscle doesn't extend big toe. These guys extend other toes. So this is extensor digitorum longus. Yay! Function is extension. Extension for what? Digitorum. Digitorum means toes. Then size is longus. Plus there should be brevis. Extensor digitorum brevis. So again, if you understand these rules, it's going to be much easier to memorize anatomical terminology. I hope this video gives you help to memorize name of muscles. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.